Hi, my name's Jeff Hall. I've just finished up one of my wave coaching clinics here in lovely Moulay, Morocco. I thought I'd take a chance to give you guys some top rigging tips. And today I'm going to talk about the boom height, the harness line position and the harness line length, another great contentious issue, and also the outhaul trim to help you to get the best out of your equipment. Once again, if you don't tune, you can't get the best out of your equipment and find out what works best for you. It's windsurfing is tough enough, so get into your tuning and help yourself out. So let's firstly talk about the boom height. Boom height makes a big difference to producing power and controlling power. So for me, on my Ezzies, for example, I have these numbers on here. So I know that if I want a bit more power and the sail to plane a bit earlier, I move my boom up to maybe 4¾. If I'm overpowered and want a bit more control and perhaps do more work on my jibes or my wave riding, I move the boom down. So, put your boom up for power, down for control. Yep. Next up, we can talk about your harness line position and your harness line length. You might have these little dots on your boom, which can be a good reference point. So, just for me on my Ezzy, I'm on 3¾ dots for my 4.7 meter sail. It'll go further back, the bigger the sail, and further forward, the smaller the sail. Right? If you haven't got these dots, then you can mark at your one point you know works a lot of the time, where you can measure 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and a bit hand widths. Yeah? Or sometimes elbow to tip. Find your way, find your front harness line position. If your lines are in the wrong place, your hands are in the wrong place, and it's going to put a lot of hard work on your hands and a lot of hard work on your body. In terms of the distance apart, I have mine quite close together, and if you'd like them a bit further apart, then you can move them up to a hand width apart. Any wider than that, and actually you can start to oversheet the sail and situations like that. I like my irons close together so I can get my hands close together for getting up planing and for getting upwind and also for top turning in my wave riding. Now that big bone of contention, the harness line length, yeah? If you want to be able to control the power in the sail using your hips, get the rig upright in lulls, get your body weight down in gusts, you need longer harness lines. I'm elbow to the end of my palm, so the end of my calluses, yeah, end of my palm touches the boom. Right, if you're learning longer lines, go to the middle of your palm. If your lines are too short, your rig will not be upright and you can't get your hands in the right place on the boom. Try sailing one-handed is a great tip to work out why you need long harness lines. Okay, so I've talked to you about your boom height, your harness line position, and your harness line length. Now I'm talking to you about the outhaul. So the outhaul, assuming your sail is rigged up with medium downhaul, this gives you, or for me I find the biggest rigging range of less outhaul or more outhaul, and the outhaul is really easy to adjust and it makes a huge difference. You can do it in the water, you can do it in the shore break, it's really easy to adjust and requires a bit less fine tuning. So for me, myself, I rigged on medium outhaul. I know I'm medium outhaul because I'm on 1/62 of my boom length and I have the maximum outhaul is 1/63 on my sail there. So read your numbers on your sail and if I know that if I take it all the way out to the end, I have near my maximum outhaul, yeah, and so I have the maximum out of control. More outhaul, more control. Then you have a flatter sail and more control if you're overpowered. So what you can do is increase your outhaul by a centimetre or two if you're overpowered. If you're underpowered and the wind's dropped a little bit, then you can let off your outhaul. Letting off your outhaul is like putting a few extra litres of power in your car's engine. Right? So that's your outhaul. Play with your outhaul. Tune your outhaul. Understand to get the best out of your equipment. If you're not tuning, you're not getting the best out of your sailing and your equipment. Last little tip, I tend to wrap my rope around my rope. On carbon booms, for example, it's very slippy. So what happens there is it can come undone. So I wrap my rope around my rope. That stays done up and you can get it undone. So, hope you found today's rigging tips helpful. Talked about the boom height, harness line position, harness line length, and the outhaul. I'm Jem Hall. Have a good night.